think there might be a knockout?
You know, whenever two people are in the ring, there's a possibility you could die any moment in there. There's always that possibility. It's always there.
Who you know?
That was a body shot.
If they don't return.
Hey, you gotta be focused. You ain't focused on what you're doing, you ain't got nothing. When they're sending it at you, you gotta be focused and send it right back at them. That's what I do, the RJ way.
What's your first focus? What do you first look
at? We got to seek and destroy, because he's not going to stand still and slug it out with Mike. And, you know, he's going to run like a thief. It's a boxing term. Fighters get in there and they run around like a thief. The bottom line is Mike will seek and destroy. Well, we've graduated from the hard work, hitting the bat, doing the pad work. He's at one with Coach Raphael. It's all becoming second nature. This is the final stage in preparation towards building towards fight night. Mike is constant. Laser beam focused. All they see is black venom in my silhouette. Becoming a roaring blaze of confidence. He's been there, but he's taking it to another level. Throwing blows in this square circle to see who's best. Mike, don't hurt him. What they scream, wait, what they mean? Tyson put in work, his head touched the whole.
Die any moment in there. There's always that possibility. It's always there.
6 weeks out. Preparation's been very difficult. Staying focused is even harder. Because you got 6 weeks, you gotta focus on nothing but fighting another man. And when you have all these additives in life, kids, fighters you're training, you have everything going on around you, it's very difficult to focus, but you must somehow. And when you find a way to focus, you gotta learn how to find a way to stay focused. Because focusing is one thing, but staying focused is another. What better element to make me hold my focus than Mike Tyson?